Hello and welcome to this tutorial video, how you can record your PowerPoints with your voice narrations and make them videos that you can share in Schoology. This is a pretty neat tool that you have in PowerPoint. So this is available to you with PowerPoint on your desktop. So PowerPoint that's on your Surface Pro device. And there's two main ways that you're going to be able to use this recording tool. One is the slideshow tab here at the top, and it has record slideshow, so we'll be able to use that. The other place that you can do this is a recording tab. I prefer the recording tab because you're going to have the recording and exporting to video all in that same ribbon, but that recording tab might not be displaying on your PowerPoint. You can check this to see if you can get the tab out there. So pretty much you would just have to click File, then click on Options, and then from here you want to click on Customize the Ribbon on the left hand side, and you're looking at this second column on the right hand side, and you just want to make sure that where it says Recording, it might be unchecked like that. You just want to make sure it's checked, and then you would click OK, and then it could display. So this is a new tab that's in PowerPoint 2019, but if you don't have it, you're not able to display it, you can get to both of these features outside of this recording tab. So again, slideshow will have that recording slideshow that we're going to use in a moment. And under File and Export, we'll have create a video, and there's your create video button that we would have under the recording tab. So if you have recording tab, fantastic. It's a great tab to have because you have all your tools there. If not, those tools are still here, just a couple of different places to go. All right, so recording the PowerPoint, one thing to keep in mind is make sure your PowerPoint's all updated, you know, do those additions first. Also, I recommend that you update your notes section underneath each of the slides. You have this notes area at the bottom. So this is a place you can put an outline, talking points, even a script you can put here in this. So this is for each slide that you can do this. So just click on the slide and add it there at the bottom. Also, be mindful that the recording of the PowerPoint will also have a video feature that shows you as the presenter. And I'll show you how to turn off the web camera or turn it on if you would like. But just kind of think about your environment that you're going to be recording in. The other thing I would recommend is sometimes you might want to put in a blank slide. And the reason for that is every so often you can have a virtual whiteboard with this recording tool. So you can, you know, work out a problem or write, and it's in live time that the video will record it with your narration. So this is a good way, just like if you were using the whiteboard or if you're using your document camera, this is a place that you could have a space every so often within your presentation. So think about that as well, where you might want to put some blank slides. All right, so again, to record, under slideshow, record slideshow, record from beginning, or the recording tab, same button, record slideshow, record from beginning. And then when you do that, they'll both end up right here and you see me because it's gonna have the camera here. I think it's a good idea if you can get your environment, you're mindful of that, to do the web camera video. The reason is it's another way for the audience who's watching the video, the students, to have that connection to you again as the teacher, not just to hear you, but to see you. So that's a good way to have that connection with these instructional videos. You're probably, hopefully, happy to see me in this video. So I think those things do help. A couple things that you have here is I'll just give you a tour before we begin. Up in the top, you have your record button. You click that when you're ready to actually do the recording. This will also turn into a pause button. So I like that because you can pause it, kind of collect yourself, and then resume when you're ready. You also have a stop button when you feel that you're done. And you have a replay so you can watch it and see if it's something that you like or if you have to do a recording again. One reason why I paid attention to that notes area earlier on in this video is of this button. So if you click it, you're going to be able to see those notes that you have per slide. This is not recorded with the whole video. That's just for you to see, which is pretty cool. You can increase it, which I would need just to see it, so you can increase it, the text size on those talking points. A couple other things on the bottom right-hand corner. This is the one that I was mentioning, the icon that looks like a person. If you click it, it turns off that video, so you're not using that web camera. You can click it again to see you. This right here, this is to turn the camera off as well. So you don't have that. So you can turn that on. So you kind of need both of those on to see ya. And then right here, you want to be careful. You don't want to click on this one. If you did, it looks like that, and you wouldn't hear me. You wouldn't hear someone. It wouldn't get your microphone. So you definitely don't want to turn that one off. And you notice if you turn them off, they have the slash or the line through them. So you definitely don't want that on your microphone. When you're doing it. Up at the settings at the top, you can change if your camera, which camera it's facing, if it was facing the back or front. So that's a place you can change that. Also, depending on the microphone, it should pick up the microphone that you have on your device. But if you plug one in, just make sure that it's connected to that one as well. So that's under settings. And then one more thing is just at the very bottom, you have a highlighter. You have a pen to annotate, digital annotations, and you have an eraser, and you have all these great colors that you can use. You also have a timer in the bottom left-hand corner. All right, so let's get started. I'll just do a maybe two or three slides demonstration. So we'll click record. You'll get a countdown to get ready. Hi, welcome class, California Studies Weekly 4, day 2. Where is that? There it is, day 2. So we're going to be looking at early communities around the world. What is our focus question? Can you see that right there in the middle? So let me circle it. And the focus question we're going to look at today, how do new inventions and discoveries shape civilizations? So that's what we're going to be doing here. And then I'll click the next slide button. So those are those arrows that you see on the left and right side and the edges of the screen. The objectives that we're going to be doing today. So I'll try out the highlighter, pick a color. So let's first look at our reading objective. So we will identify and cite key details in the text. And then you can use a different color if you want for a highlighter. Highlight it. And look at the language objective. We will use academic language and complete sentences in your writing practices today. And then let me just get to a slide. Here it is, where that's the blank slide. Again, these are really useful to have, so I suggest kind of put those within your slideshow where you need them. But as you can see, this is a place that you can use the pen and you can write, you can show your work. And this would be very similar to if you're using the whiteboard or a digital stylus or a document camera in the classroom. And it will record what you're doing in live video form, which is pretty neat. All right, so as I said again, up in the top left is that pause button. So sometimes you might take a pause. I know recording for too long, you don't want to mess up. So every so often pause, kind of get a break on it before you continue on. And then you just click record if you want to continue on. The really cool thing I like about this tool is up here in the top right-hand corner, you have a clear button. So if you click clear, you can redo just this one slide. Maybe you messed up, and you can just do a re-recording of just that one slide. You don't have to re-record your whole presentation, which is pretty huge in these recording tools. So I will say PowerPoint has done that really nice. I wish that was in more of our recording tools that we had, but PowerPoint's doing it really well. So props to Microsoft on that one. But you can re-record all your slides if you want, but you can just do one slide, say, I want to do this one over, and continue on. When you feel that you're all finished, just press the stop button up at the very top left. And in the top right-hand corner, you'll have to click the X. So you'll click that X in the top right. And once you click the X, you'll return back. One thing that you're going to want to be really careful, though, is be careful of the save buttons. If you save it, it's going to overwrite your current PowerPoint with these annotations, with the videos in the corner, with your all those annotations. So if you still want to keep that pristine PowerPoint, don't save it at this point. Instead, I suggest exporting it as a video file because that's going to be the easiest way to share it in Schoology. So the recording tab, if you did have that, has that export video. Or if you were using the slideshow record button, then you would just need to go to File, Export, Create Video, and you have this Create Video button. Both of those export video buttons lead you here. So no matter which tab you had, you still come at this place right here. So you click Create Video. And then you're going to pick the place that you want to save it to. Remember the location, remember the file name, because you'll need to know that once we upload it to Schoology. And click Save. And then what you want to also pay attention to is at the very bottom of your screen right here, there's a progress bar. So you want to keep PowerPoint open. It needs to save it. This is going to start to fill up this progress bar as it's saving that video. So you don't want to exit out of PowerPoint yet. So you want to keep letting that save, and we'll see in a moment when it's all finished. All right, when you see the progress bar has finished, that means it's all saved, and you can go and preview it if you like. Just go to your file folder. Remember the location that you saved it to. Here it is. And double-click on it. And you can see
Class,
that video
California
file,
Studies,
and you
Weekly
can
4,
preview it.
Day.
So stay tuned to the next videos, and I'll show you how you can upload these videos that you save from PowerPoint and share them in Schoology so your students can see them. Thank you.